G'day and welcome to Splitsy's Survival Tutorial Series. This video is going to cover making a basic cargo rover with remote control blocks. In the previous videos, we've built and then optimized a mining ship that had a cockpit. That isn't the only way to control vehicles in Space Engineers. There are times when a remote control is advantageous. In this case, we're going to build a rover that is capable of having the mining ship land on it, so that you could theoretically drive it to a nearby mine site, drill out some ore, and dump it into the rover rather than fly all the way back to base. Instead of having to switch cockpits to drive the rover back, we'll simply use a remote control block from the cockpit of the miner to drive there and back. Let's begin by setting up our G menu. For convenience, at the start, let's add the light armor blocks, then the passenger seat, remote control, small reactor, battery, wheel group, gyroscopes, medium cargo container, and conveyor junction. Just like with the mining ship, we start on our platform with the H-shaped blocks. Raise a pillar off them and then extend it out to three blocks on each side. I like to use some ramp blocks to create some extra clearance underneath the vehicle and attach the wheels to those. You can access the extra blocks with your mouse scroll wheel under the light armor blocks. When placing the wheels, it's important to note which way up the wheels are and which of the left and right wheels you are using. To have the wheel in the correct orientation, the angled piston that looks a little like an elbow should be on top. The 3x3 and 5x5 wheels are going to be your best choice, as the 1x1 aren't really practical for anything large or anything that's got to traverse even the slightest rough terrain. I'm arbitrarily deciding that this first axle that we're building is going to be the front, so we'll line up the left and right 3x3 wheels on each side. Now we've got a front axle, we can extend toward the rear about 15 blocks and repeat the process to place another two wheels on the rover. Make sure you remember which side you put each wheel type, as it makes things easier later. Although the wheel types are cosmetic changes only, I like to make them correct by name so that I can easily pick which wheels are which in the control panel. Alright, let's weld all this up and get on to the next pieces. Now we've got four wheels, it looks like this rover's taking shape. We can add a seat for when we want to control the rover more directly. You can theoretically place this anywhere, but the front can be handy as your suit's lights will then be secondary headlights, and it just makes orientation a bit easier, at least for me. With a place to sit, we also need a way to control this, so place a remote control block. Where this is placed on the rover does not matter at all, but its orientation is critically important. Using the control panel icon as a guide can be useful here. The picture is oriented the correct way up, and the front of the block is the part with the circular light on it. We want this to be correct, otherwise our controls will be all over the place and it'll be really, really hard to drive this thing. Build a row of armor blocks roughly in the middle of the ship. These will be our supports for our cargo containers. On top of these, place the conveyor junction with the large port on the top and one facing the front and rear of the rover. Another way to say this is make sure the small ports are facing each side of the rover. Attach a few medium cargo containers in front and behind the conveyor junction, being careful that the conveyor ports line up correctly. On the top side of the conveyor junction, add a connector. This is where the mining ship will land and connect to the rover. Place a battery in the front and two reactors on the small ports of the cargo container. Gyroscopes are technically not required on rovers, but I find they can be helpful to get you out of trouble if you're moving quickly over bumpy terrain, and if you build enough of them, you can even flip over an upside down rover. We're not going to build that many. Two will suffice for our purposes here. Build all those bits and get a little uranium on board for the reactors. With all those pieces built, we can take the rover for a little test drive. I'm not a big fan of four-wheel steering, so let's turn off the steering on the rear wheels. This is where the placement of the correctly named wheels makes life easier. Since the rear wheels were placed last, we can simply look for the wheel of each side with the highest number allocated to it. Since the defaults for the other wheel settings were changed, making a rover is so much easier than it used to be. We could just leave all the settings alone, but I personally like my suspension to have a little bit more stiffness, so I'm going to increase the strength of the suspension. We can now safely grind off the support column and attempt to drive off. Hop in the seat and find the remote control block in the control panel. In its settings, you can find a button that says control, which, conveniently, allows you to control the rover. Unfortunately, it looks like the rover is just going to push the build support, not roll over it, so we'll grind away a few more blocks, and then we can clear the platform. The rover should be able to comfortably handle the bump off the platform the way it's set up, and with how little weight is on board. If you only want to have a manually controlled rover, that's all you need to do. But let's make this thing a little bit more useful and add some real remote control capability. What we need for that is to build an antenna. I don't have enough radio components for it, so I'll go to my assembler and order up the parts. Once the antenna is completed, you can get the remote control menu in two ways. The quickest way is to press Shift plus K, or you can just press K and navigate to the remote tab. If you named your rover, it will show up with its name here. But since I was lazy, my rover is called, drumroll, Small Grid 2789. Click the Take Control button and we're now driving a giant remote controlled car. Driving it without being able to look around isn't ideal, so let's add a camera to the front and then we'll be able to see exactly where we're going. The camera is another block that needs to be placed in the correct orientation. For small ships, the little dot should be in the bottom left corner of your camera for it to be upright. Now just weld the camera in that position. We can then control the ship again and add the camera to the ship's hotbar with a view command. Select this and you'll see directly from the camera at the front of the rover. The last thing to do with this rover is test its ability to carry the mining ship. Grab the mining ship and fly over to the rover's connector and dock. Once you're docked, turn off your thrusters, go to your remote control menu, and take control of the rover. You're now driving the rover from the cockpit of the small ship and can drive off into the sunset, or whatever you want to do. Something to note here is, if you get out of the mining ship and then get into a control point for the rover, try not to press the parking brake key, which is P, because that will also disconnect the connector that's holding the mining ship in place. It'll then tumble off the top and may get badly damaged. I hope this tutorial was useful for those of you wanting to build your first rover. This was a very basic and ugly design, but should get you started on building your own awesome machines. The next tutorial in this series will be building a hydrogen-powered ship that can escape the gravitational influence of our planet, so we can go mine some asteroids, or moons, or go to an alien planet and die to Sabroids. See you then!